Hi guys, Rev Jock here. Welcome back to the channel. And we're just in pre-season at the moment. The European Championships are currently going on, and I believe, miracle of miracle, Scotland has just beaten Italy. See Che Adams and Jay Brown. Blimey. Anyway. Now, there's been a few things happening. I've been offered a couple of jobs, would you believe? We'll get to that in a moment. I just want to show you some business I've done. I've extended a few contracts to some of the young lads. Luca Vatta extended his contract. He's looking forward to continuing his career with such a talented group of players. Good lad. I believe he's Albanian. I think, actually, the more I think on it now, I think he's the only non-Scot in my squad. Oh, hang on. I think Longy's from Northern Ireland. But yeah, it's a predominantly Scottish squad. Ben Williamson signed a new contract. Keep him here for another 2 years at least. Jack Collins managed to get another year on Jack's contract. That was all I could get. Ross Docherty, 2 years for Ross. I think that's a good signing. Played well last season. Happy with that one. Russell McLean, of course, the 30-goal striker. He's delighted to be working under me due to his admiration for me. The feeling's mutual, Russell lad. Liam Parker. Now, Liam Parker is a left-back, and I've got him in a three-year deal for some reason. A lot of them wouldn't accept 3 years, but this boy did, so good on you, son. I won't forget it. Lee Gibson signed a new one, just a year for Lee at the moment. I tried a cheeky bid for Tony Weston on loan from Rangers, striker. Quite a prolific striker on his day, actually. Rangers accepted the offer, but Mr. Weston himself later rejected it, unfortunately. Lee Gibson, I think we've been here before. 1 year for Lee. Now I did manage to get someone on loan from Rangers, who also actually became... I got an affiliate agreement with them. I asked the board to find me someone, and Rangers was the best club that they offered me. So I've got Robbie Fraser in. He's a left back. He's given me a little bit more cover at left back. And it's only a 6 month loan, unfortunately. But I'll take us up to Christmas, so it could be a help. Right. Now, this boy, Jack Collins, this is very interesting. Signed him free as a schoolboy, as you may recall from the last episode. Now, Ross County, the cheeky buggers, have made an offer of $3,500, eventually rising to $15,500. Naturally, I knocked him back. Then, before you could say, tickle my fancy, in between times, our broth offered me the job. I thought long and hard about it and then said, nah, bollocks. And what else did we find? I'm sure there was another offer for Jack Collins. Anyway, see this offer here, this $15,500. They came back with another offer, and I believe it was going to eventually rise to $25,000. Which made me think, you know, we got a good one here with this boy. So anyway, I turned that down. So let's get back to the present day. That's you up to date. I've also put an offer in for Kevin Hanratty. Now, Kevin Hanratty can play on the wide. He's currently at Aberdeen, but he's released on a free. I think, if memory serves me, I've put the offer in. Yeah, I have. So we're just waiting to find out what Mr. Hanratty decides, if he wants to come down to the Central Belt and live the high life in Dumbarton. I got another player in, guys, as well. Now have a look at this boy. The name is Scott McGill. Likes to hang about the midfield. Decent bit of potential, quite aggressive, brave. Nothing out of the ordinary. Let's just see his history. He was a Hearts boy, so probably picked up some good training over the years. And what did I pay? I think it was a free, sorry, it was a free transfer, yeah. But yeah, so I'm very happy with that. That's an extra bit of cover in the midfield. Let me think. What are we going to do here, son? We'll give him a bit of strength and endurance. He looks like he could do with a good meal inside him. No disrespect, son. Jack Collins, after the adulation shown to him by Ross County, it made me think. And I thought, you know, I better sign this boy on a bit more of a contract. So I got him up to 2026 now. So they can keep offering and they'll keep getting turned down. Dumbarton's stature in the game remains intact. I've also signed up Callan Hambrook. He's on a 3-year deal now, which is great. Absolutely fantastic. Very impressed with the way he played last season. 35 appearances, 4 goals, 14 assists. Absolutely fantastic. So great to have the boy signed up. Let me just see what else we can... Another one I've got signed up on a 2-year deal, Adam Frizzell. Someone tell me in the comments, is it Frizzle, Frizzell? Anyway, glad to have him. Recap on last season. He 36 appearances, 9 goals, 7 assists, 3 Player of the Match awards. Excellent. Well done, son. Good to have you on board. Another one I've signed up for 3 years now. Regan Mimno. Good lad. 22-year-old defensive midfielder, as you know, from last season. Finlay Gray has also been signed up on a 2-year. Calvin Orsi, I managed to talk him round. He wanted to leave. Said he wanted to get away from Dumbarton. I managed to talk him round, explaining the virtues of the place. That's just about us up to date for now, guys. I'm going to see if I can make any more signings. And let's just look at this guy before he go. He's a no-nonsense right-back. Where's he been? Dundee United, downfield, breaking. Could get him on a free, what do you think? Would be a terrific signing for the future. There you are. We'll have a think about that, and next time you're back, we'll let you know what's happening. So now we're just back with the squad. We're going to welcome them back. Welcome back, everyone. I've had a chance to think over the last few weeks, and I think I wasn't being ambitious enough in our last meeting. If all of you give me 100%, there's no reason we can't make the playoffs. Go on, I'll do that. Oh, they're happy with that. Excellent. That's exactly the sort of reaction I was after. I'll also be expecting us to give a good account of ourselves in the Scottish Cup this season. Not too bad. Doherty's satisfied. Brilliant. That's just what I wanted to hear. I don't want to make any promises for now. I hope you all understand this. I also appreciate your collective support and adherence to the code of conduct. Thank you. Positive. That's it. They're all happy. No unhappiness in the squad. Just a recap. I put in an offer for a guy. Was it Michael MacArthur? He'll probably pop up in a moment. I put an offer in for him. I think it was 7,000. I had to bid 7,000 or so. So that's in the process of going through. We'll find out if he wants to come down to Dumbarton. Brett Long signed a 2-year deal. That's good. Actually, the director of football negotiated a lot of these for me, so got to thank him for that. Now, this is part of the affiliate deal. So we've got a friendly with Rangers on Saturday the 6th of July. So expect a big crowd. Expect to raise a little bit of money for that. So good stuff. This is boy Mark McKenzie, and Mark has agreed to join us. Oh no, sorry, I'm getting mixed up with McKenzie and something else. This is a boy I bought a couple of years last season from Ayr United for 18,000. top scorer in his first season. Not so good last season because he couldn't get in the team because of young McLean's performance. So anyway, we keep him at the club. He's actually now that I come to remember, there was an offer on the table from, I can't remember. They offered a fair bit of money and I told them to get knotted. So there you are. Well, we're here. We'll just have a, this is next year, by the way. This is 25th of June, 2024. Let's have a look at the European Championships. What's going on? Oh, blimey, we're in with England again and Holland and Italy. That's a group of certain death. Never mind the group of death. Blimey. We've won one. We've lost one. Lost to Holland. Oh, God, we've got to play England in a decider now. We'll keep an eye on that. Let's see if there's anything else of interest up here. Belgium, Germany, Portugal, Serbia, all top of the groups. Anyway, we'll keep an eye on the England game coming up then. Let's just agree to most of this. I know it's a bit boring for you guys. Run with the ball down the right. Like I say, I was curious to see what was going to happen. This is Kevin Hanratty has agreed to join us. It's a deal that is a free transfer, I believe. Free transfer, that's good. Let's just remind ourselves of, oh yeah, he's an attacking midfielder and playing a left or in the middle. Nice bit of cover. Very good signing for the future, the scout report says. So there we are. That's good. I'm happy. I'm really confident for this team now. I think we can make a real good push in League One here. Who knows, we might end up in a championship this time next year. Here he is, Kevin Hanratty. Attacking midfielder. Let's see what we can give him here. I'll train him in a final third. There we are. Ask Mackenzie to welcome him. Go on, Mark. Say hello. Put your arm around him. Give him a hug. Tell him, take him down a stag's head. Now, with loan offers for Luca Vata. Now, this, I think it's a good idea. I think he's just too raw to go in the first team at the moment. So you know what I'll do? I don't really want to look into this too much. I'll accept all offers. And we'll see him next year when he comes back. Ask him all about it. Oh, the assistant manager's happy with Hanratty. Good on you, Frank. We did have a chat last night, if you remember, about this. Oh, Scotland 2, England 2. Let's see what's happening here. Oh, blimey, where are you going? Turnbull scores for Scotland. Foden and Kane for England. And Ollie McBurney, would you believe, equalises. So what does this mean? What does this mean, I hear you ask? It means we qualify for some reason. Three teams qualify. Oh, well, happy days. First time ever out of groups, eh? Right. I know this is dragging on a bit and you're probably switching off in your droves. This Jack Collins, this is a boy, remember? The big bid from Ross County can become a top player. Could become much better than Mark McKenzie, blimey. We could be onto something here. Here's Michael MacArthur. This is the boy I was telling you about. 6.5 it cost me. We're going to accept that. 10% of next sale if I sell him on. Let's just remind ourselves who he is. He's a right back. Give me a bit of cover back there. Tackling 12, aggression 13, fitness 15. That'll do me. Welcome to the club, son, and I'll get Big Buchanan to welcome you. Give him a hug, put an arm around him. There you go. You're here for the draw. Oh, fantastic. Now let's view the draw in all its glory. Draw next team. Draw all teams. Right, let's see who we got. If you can spot us before I can. There we are down the bottom, look. We're in with Falkirk, Hamilton, Kilmarnock and Stranraer. Now, if I was a betting man, I would say we could get out of this group. I would say, you know what, bring it on. Now, I understand that this is going to be quite a long episode because I'm blethering away like a fishwife. But we got this friendly coming up. You know, are we going to... Mark McKenzie's been the best trainer. There you go, son. You trained really well, keep it up. And Regan, you've been a naughty. So, Harry's put pen to paper. He's now in the door. It's all official. There's not going to be any last minute hitches. It's all official. He's in the door. Welcome, Harry boy. Now, we just got to find your place in that midfield, and that could be the problem, because my midfield has been outstanding. But it's good to have competition. We're going on all fronts this season. League One, Premier Sports Cup, the Scottish FA Cup, the other thing that I can't remember. But we're going on all fronts, and we're going to compete in them all. So squad depth is vital, absolutely vital. And we got this Rangers game up tomorrow now. I'm tempted to play it. Harry Cochran, what are we going to give you? Passing. Get your passing in order, son. Calvin, welcome. Put our arm around him, give him a hug and all that jazz. Right. Harry Cochran in the door. I'll use his squad for this friendly because I'm like that. A capacity crowd of 2,020 is expected for a friendly clash. Right, let's... Callum, well done, son. Keep it up. Robbie Fraser again. I'm going to... You know what, son? I'm going to need to discuss this with you. Advice. Warn player. Criticise conduct. I'm disappointed with your recent conduct. It doesn't show the best of this club. I think you're a bit harsh on me. I'll continue to work hard and do my best for the club. Cheers. See you later. Okay, I'll let you off. There's two warnings now, son, you know. Right, now this is the thing here. Oh, this, I may need to take some time with this. He's got McKenzie up top. I want McLean up top. Frizzell, Hambrook. See, this is a midfield I like. I've got young Fraser there. Got Williamson. This is going to be tricky. I've got... Where's this new boy? Where is he? Harry Cochran. Welcome into the fold, son. There's MacArthur as well. And there's another guy, Hanratty, isn't there? Where's Hanratty? I don't see him. Anyway, Lukavata is going on loan. Excuse me for changing the subject. He's gone to Hurlford, wherever that is. I should have checked. You know, it's good to check the loans to make sure they're going to get playing time and all that, but I've got a lot of stress this week with a big friendly coming up and everything. I'll, anyway, look, we got... Let's just see here. Let's see what's going to be the best. Liam Parker. See, he was my right back. Okay, I'll leave it as it is. Now, you know what? Let's, where's Hanratty? That's bugging me a little bit now. I'm sure I signed somebody called Hanratty. I'll find him for the next game. But anyway, you know, we're just going to, boy, don't let it happen again. Right. Let me see what's happening here. If there's anything exciting comes up, I'm more concerned with what's going on with the European Championships now. I shouldn't have tuned in the first place to that. Ah, excellent news. Head of Youth Development Scott Wilson has so far failed to... not so good news. What's up with you, Scott, old lad? Anyway, keep trying. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And as of today, we've sold 69 season tickets. Ah, now this is interesting. This was a boy from Hearts, surely to God. At Hearts, these years ago. Do you think this could be a good signing? Where's he playing now, in the middle? I wonder if it might be worth putting a wee cheeky offer in here. It will do the old installments. I wonder if they'll accept us. So they want 19,250 in total. Now, I don't know, I'll need to go into the bank manager here, but I think we can get them down a little bit. If I can get them down to 15. I'll put the offer in and see how we go with that. He could be a very useful player. Certainly if he's interested here. 19,000 I offered. Blimey. I better go under the chairman quick style. Start negotiations. Important player. Negotiate contract. Oh, that's way too much. Get him down to 350. He's not getting the promotion wage rise. 475, 425. See how we go here. There we are. Welcome to the club, Harry boy. Quite flummoxed me a little bit because, look, there you are. That's just paid for Harry Cochran. Dumbarton have been paid 37,000 and a bit for their continued footballing partnership with the Rangers. There you are. That's paid for Harry Cochran. I don't need to go and see the chairman. Here we are, we've hit the headlines. Well, we've just beat Norway 2-1. Blimey, that's quite astonishing. As in real life, we just beat Norway 2-1 last week. Norway took the lead and we got two goals. This is a parallel universe, you could say. Shea Adams and Turnbull. Turnbull's doing well for Scotland in this. But anyway, I know I'm sorry. I'll carry on that. Liam Parker, well done, son. Training well. Keep it up. Robbie Fraser, not training well. Get a finger out, son. I'll send you back to Ibrox with your tail between your legs. So, Harry's put pen to paper. He's now in the door. It's all official. There's not going to be any last-minute hitches. It's all official. He's in the door. Welcome, Harry boy. Now, we just got to find you a place in that midfield, and that could be the problem, because my midfield has been outstanding. But it's good to have competition. We're going on all fronts this season. League One, Premier Sports Cup, the Scottish FA Cup, the other thing that I can't remember. But we're going on all fronts, and we're going to compete in them all. So squad depth is vital, absolutely vital. Harry Cochran, what are we going to give you? Passing. Get your passing in order, son. Calvin, welcome. Put your arm around him, give him a hug and all that jazz. Harry Cochran in the door. Use his squad for this friendly because a capacity crowd of 2020 is expected for a friendly clash. Callum, well done, son. Keep it up. Robbie Fraser again. You know what, son? I'm going to need to discuss this with you. Advice. Warn player. Criticise conduct. I'm disappointed with your recent conduct. It doesn't show the best of this club. I think you're a bit harsh on me. I'll continue to work hard and do my best for the club. Cheers. See you later. Okay, I'll let you off. There's two warnings now, son, you know? Right, now this is the thing here. I may need to take some time with this. He's got McKenzie up top. I want McLean up top. Frizzell, Hambrook. See, this is a midfield I like. I've got young Fraser there. I've got Williamson. This is going to be tricky. Where's this new boy? Where is he? Harry Cochran. Welcome into the fold, son. There's MacArthur as well. And now there's another guy, Hanratty, isn't there? Where's Hanratty? Anyway, Luca Vatta is going on loan. Excuse me for changing the subject. He's gone to Hurlford, wherever that is. I should have checked. You know, it's good to check the loans to make sure they're going to get playing time and all that. But I've got a lot of stress this week with a big friendly coming up and everything. Anyway, look, we got Liam Parker. See, he was my right back. Okay, I'll leave it as it is. Now, you know what? Where's Hanratty? That's bugging me a little bit now. I'm sure I signed somebody called Hanratty. I'll find them for the next game. But anyway, you know, we're just going to... Scotland are out of the tournament. 1-0 defeat to Croatia. Pasalic in the 11th minute. Well, there we are. Also, we lost the friendly 3-1. And Russell McLean got sent off right at the end of the game. Silly boy. Anyway, we've got another friendly against Falkirk coming up. And I think my team is just about ready for the new season. It's going to be interesting. The players I've brought in, the improvements I've made. That's an interesting name. Early signs of a terrific signing. He's 29. What are the early signs exactly? Let's see the boy's history here. Clyde Bradford, St Johnson. Oh, he's been here before. Before my time. I wonder. Let's compare him. I don't think he's been scouted properly, that's the thing. No, he's not been scouted. Maybe that's what they mean by early signs, before the scouting. Do you think it's worth... Is it worth it? Let's see what it's going to cost us. Why can't I just put an offer in? Contract. Approach to sign. Sorry. Star player? No. Important player? Maybe. Nah, okay, star player. Oh, I can't pay that. Three, 3-5. Nah, walk away, it's too much. I don't want to create disharmony in a squad. If you roll up and say, I'll get a grand away gear, and young James and young Scott, and I'm only getting 400, how come you're getting a grand a week? Who are you? I don't want disharmony in a squad. Life goes on. Let's see if the scouts have got any more. Let's have a quick look. Come with me down the rabbit hole. See, I don't think we need anything really badly. Ross Millen, fullback. Suleiman Mandy, Rangers midfielder. I wonder if we could get him on loan. Make an offer. Loan. Regular starter. Defensive midfielder. Anchor. See what happens. Might be a bit of cover in the midfield there. Might benefit the squad. Anyway, where was I? Yeah, I don't want disharmony. I don't want one player on £1,100 a week and the rest on 3 and 4. That's just my philosophy. Skip to recommendations. Head meeting. We can't be arsed with anything. Dumbarton outline loan intentions for Mandy. Now, Solomon Mandy. Let's have a wee... just compare him with... For example, Adam Frizzell. You know what? I think our boy holds his own here. Anyway, if he comes in, he's a bit of extra cover. It's not going to cost us anything. Oh, blimey, he's coming. Soliman Mandy has agreed to join the club. The chance of more playing time is a considerable factor in his decision. Head physio Kirsten Murray has given Soliman Mandy a clean bill of health after the player cleared his medical without any immediate concerns. Come on, son. Come on down. Keep out of the Stag's Head at the weekend. So, this is looking like my... I think this is possibly my strongest 11 at the moment. I toyed with McKenzie or McLean as a as a forward. I toyed with Frizzle or Mimna. I put Cochrane in here, moved Mimna further forward. I've gone with a young boy, Fraser, at left back. I'm sticking with Williamson at right back. But these things can change. I got a nice headache now, I think you'll call it. I got Hanratty can come in, Mandy. I think I'm going to start the season with this squad and see how we go. So it's going to be like last season, guys. I'm going to simulate the season ahead, see what happens, you know? If I had to put money on it, I think we're going to get promotion this season. I'm confident. I'm confident in the boys, and let's see what happens. Well, guys, I'm afraid to say the season didn't turn out quite as well as expected. I'll just show you the table there. Now, it was a bit of a nail-biter on the final day. We just avoided relegation on the very final day of the season. So, let's be thankful for small mercies, I guess. Some strange things happened this season. I'll take you through it now. Let's see where to begin. Premier Sports Cup, not too bad. We beat Stranraer 2-1. Beat Falkirk 3-0. Lost to Hamilton on a penalty shootout. Beat Kilmarnock 2-1. Very good result. Started the league campaign with a defeat to Forfar. Draw with Montrose. Victory over FC Edinburgh. Then we lost to Rangers. Blimey, that looks like extra time. Yeah, we held Rangers. It went to extra time, and they beat us in extra time. So at this point in the proceedings, you're thinking things are going not too bad. We lose at home to Raith Rovers, and then we have quite a bad run coming up. Lose to Cove Rangers, draw with Airdrie Kilty Hearts, beat Partick Thistle on penalties. Let's just skip down a bit. Let's see the Scottish Cup third round. We beat Auchinlech Talbot, beat Dunfermline in the league, very good result, beat Kilty Hearts in the league, and then we had a real wild sequence, real wild. Lost away to Forfar, home to Montrose, lost 5-2 at home to Raith Rovers, lost away to FC Edinburgh, lost 4-0 to Inverness Cali in the Scottish Cup fourth round. Now that's a real bad result considering some of the other cup ties we performed reasonably well. But what's really catching the eye here is the drop-off at the end of the season. I mean, from the 15th of March, in fact, from the 8th of March till the end of the season, we drew two and lost the rest. I can't quite put my finger on what's happened here. See, when you simulate the season, like I've been doing, the assistant manager gets his grubby hands on the team. And there's a few things I want, you know, I'm gonna go down and see him later on about this. Because if you remember last season, Russell McLean was a man with, up here you see 35, 25 goals. This season he played 22 games with no goals. But that's not all. So I'll be having a word with Frank. I mean, league-wise, It's quite alarming. I mean, here we got Russell McLean started two games, came on as a sub in 28, one assist, two goals. And now it's gone back to Mark McKenzie, 45 appearances, 22 goals. I don't know what he's done. He's switched back to McKenzie for some reason. As you can see, the first season McKenzie was on fire, 36, 34 goals. Last season, he done what Russell McLean has done this season. So, I think for next season, I'm going to have to take charge and click the box that says keep the team. I'll let Frank pick the team. More fool me. He'll be down a job centre Monday morning, Frank, I'll tell you that. Oh, it's frustrating. It's really frustrating. I thought this squad was on the verge of greatness. The good thing is, and it is a good thing, if you look at some of these boys here, who Frizzell, one of my new signings, is playing really well. 4 goals, 3 assists. Regan Mimna, 4 assists, 5 goals. Callum Hambrook, 7 assists, 5 goals. Harry Cochran, one assist, six goals. Good signings, these guys. And it bodes well for the future. They're just quite young, some of them, at the moment. And we got the kids to come through. We got Jack Collins here. We got Luke Graham, who's a youngster. Liam Parker. Finlay Gray's young. Ben Wilkinson's 22. Scott McGill's 23. And don't forget the real youngster, like Lee Gibson here, you know. He's going to be a player. Nothing to report in the stat sheet. But this boy is going to be very good. It, you know, all is not lost. All is not lost yet. So, let's get to the bottom of this. Several players feel you should let Liam Parker leave the club. He's got 2 years left in his contract. 2 years from now. No way he's leaving the club. What's it got to do with you lot anyway? Ross Docherty. It's very disappointing that we haven't been able to find a way to solve this problem. What problem? He's got 2 years left in his contract. He's going nowhere. No, I'm not. You're all going to have to get over it. See, sometimes it's a good thing to be strict with him. Although, Doherty's argumentative and Carswell's argumentative. Oh, well. Well, like I say earlier, a disappointing end to the season. I don't know for sure, but let's just go back and have a look here. I mean, the bottom end of this, defeat. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 15 points. Say we'd won. I know, it's a big if. Yeah, I know it's a big if. 40, 50. We could have been in the playoffs if we'd won the last five games instead of losing them. You know, that's how crazy it is. But it's annoying me. I need to take more. I need to be more hands-on. I just haven't got the time at the moment to play every game. You know, that's why I'm simulating. It's a busy job managing Dumbarton. You know, it's taking its toll on me. I might be sacked yet. You know, the chairman wants to see me later. God knows what that's about. It's not to wish me happy birthday, I don't think. But anyway, you know, I'll get back to the drawing board now. Try and sort out some recruitment. Looking ahead to next season, I'm optimistic we will be promoted as champions. Let's see what they say to that. Blimey. Okay. Taking it a bit too far, maybe the playoffs. Oh, that's better. That's what I wanted to hear. It's good to see there's some support in this dressing room for that idea. I want you to enjoy your break. We can discuss promises when you're back for pre-season. There you are. See you later, boys. Well, that's the season done, guys. And it's as I say, it's a disappointing season. Look at this screen here. See, before I went away on the simulation, I had Mimna up there. I had Frizzell out there. The young boy for Rangers. Actually, I didn't check, and I don't know if I can now, because I can't even remember his name, to be honest. I don't know how to find... Oh, hang on. Sorry, bear with me. Technical issues here. Go back to the start of the season, when I know he was in the team. Robbie Fraser. Right, he's back at Rangers. Let's see here. He played 16 games. Two assists, one player of the match, and a 6.66 rating. Not too bad, you know. He's a young kid. Then, in the second half of the season, we had Liam Parker playing that role. 36, three assists, 6.90 rating. So maybe Parker's actually... Let's work the oracle here. How do you compare with Robbie Fraser? Blimey. So Fraser's speedy and technical, but Parker is tall, good at defending, more physical. If we could kind of get a combination of both, that would be perfect. I'm depressed now. I think I might need to go down a Stag's Head and drown my sorrows. I'll take Frank down there and I'll give him a few pints and tell him some home truths. No, in fairness, it's not Frank's fault. It's me for simulating. Anyway, what I'm going to do, I'm going to wrap up the video, I guess. And I'll see you next season. Well, I'll see you in 6 weeks or so for... Let's just do the roundup here. Oh, the season's not even finished yet. Two games left, Man City. I'll come back in a minute, guys. I'll go to the end of the season. Bear with me. Right, so here we are at the end of the season. Let's just go around a few of the leagues. The date is the 28th of May, 2025. Nothing much changing in England. Man City top, Arsenal, Chelsea, Tottenham. Man United, Southampton back up there, down the bottom. Blackburn obviously came up and went back down. All right, let me see here. Napoli win the league in Italy on goal difference from Atlanta. Real Madrid again in Spain. I'm assuming Celtic won. Yeah. 20 points clear of Rangers, Aberdeen, St Mirren, Motherwell and Hibs. This time Hearts are in the bottom half. Dundee relegated, Kilmarnock in the playoff. By the look of it, Kilmarnock won the playoff. What else happened in the world? Let's just see what's happening here in the other divisions around us. League table. Dundee United win the championship. Inverness Cali come second. Ayr United are relegated, so we'll be playing Ayr again next season. I think that's about it. Well, that was... See, this boy's been injured. Maybe that's been a problem. Dumbarton's Adam Frizzell has returned to full training. 3 weeks out. See, that's coincided with our bad form. At last, I have something to blame. I'll tell the chairman. But yeah, I'm disappointed. I'd go as far as to say I'm devastated. But the only way is up. See you for next season, guys. Thanks very much. Is this the company?